Hare Krishna. Freedom is not just an opportunity, it is also a responsibility. Whenever we try to do anything constructive in our life, at that time, we all sometimes feel shackled by our situations. And few words captivate the human imagination nowadays as much as does the word or idea of freedom. We all want to be free to pursue whatever is our heart's aspiration. At the same time, while freedom is an opportunity that we cherish, that we can believe is our right, and that we believe it should be given to others also, at the same time, freedom is something which is also a major responsibility. When we are free to make our choices, then that also means that we are responsible for the consequences of our choices. And that's why we have to be conscious that we need to also become mature enough to exercise freedom in a responsible way. We see this restriction of freedom even in today's world present in so many areas. Say kids who are below the age of 16 or 18 are generally not allowed to say drive their own vehicles. Why is that? We say, isn't that a restriction on their freedom? Yes, it is. But when they are either very small or when they are the teenage years, early teenage years, with all the trauma that comes in adolescence, at that time their hormones may be so wild that they may not be capable of the responsibility that is required for driving. Driving is such a commonplace activity, and yet the freedom to drive is not given till somebody becomes responsible enough to exercise that freedom. Now, of course, we could say that even adults, whether they drive always responsibly or not, that's open to question. But in general, despite the occurrence of accidents, millions of people every day commute, and most of them commute safely. So that means most people who drive are reasonably responsible while driving. Now, what applies to driving also applies to life at large. The Bhagavad Gita concludes with acknowledging Arjuna's independence, Arjuna's freedom. Right? There is a dilemma about which course of action to follow, and he is being guided by Krishna. Although Krishna is God, he does not take away Arjuna's freedom and force him to do any particular action. But Krishna tells him to deliberate deeply. So, deliberate deeply and then do as you desire. That means that he is praying, he is basically focusing on the point that Arjuna, you have to be responsible, and that responsibility is executed through deliberation. Usually, it is the lack of deliberation or the impulsiveness that characterizes irresponsible behavior. We're driving on the road and suddenly we see something, say a hotel or a movie theater. I want to go there. We suddenly turn around. But it may not be a proper turn to take over there. Another vehicle might hit us. We might hit another vehicle. So that way, when there is proper deliberation, and not just simply deliberation, but there is the education that informs the deliberation, then we can make responsible choices. So for all of us, we already have free will, and that is an opportunity. It is spiritual knowledge that helps us to transform this, to become aware that this is also a responsibility. If we use our free will wrongly, we will go down to inauspicious destinations. We will bring distress in our lives. And if we use our free will properly, then we can attain the supreme auspiciousness. So the Bhagavad Gita helps us by informing us about how freedom is a responsibility that needs to be discharged properly. It helps us to fully tap the opportunity of freedom. Thank you. Hare Krishna.